Coming up on GET,
we stretch it out.
We take a look at the VST program.
And we travel back to a simpler time.
Houston, we have a robotics team.
The CHS robotics team has had great success this year, making it all the way to the World Championship.
Killian, give us a recap.
We have a lot of different like sub-teams in which we divide the work. Electrical, they do the wiring. Design, they design the robot. Our business and media team, they make our videos and design our website. And we also have a strategy team, and you get 6 weeks to build a robot for the game.
Our strategy has changed a lot recently. There have been a lot of developments, and really it's been a couple students, including myself, basically revolutionizing our spreadsheet technology. Taking information from scouting matches and like spitting out basically everything that we could possibly need going into either the next match or going into alliance selections.
I did not expect our team to win the St. Louis Regional. It's capable, it's just that regionals are very tough. There's over 50 teams, and it takes a lot of hard work from everybody to succeed and win a regional.
A lot of teams from all parts of the world, Mexico, Brazil, Turkey. The impact that FIRST and robotics has on people goes beyond the language barrier. At the world competition where you're up against huge, huge teams, they've been doing it for a long time and they're really good at it, it's really inspiring, really humbling to watch them and compete against them, compete on the same level as them. It makes you want to become that.
Working out brings you so many benefits.
But before you grind, you gotta stretch.
One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
switch. Liv, Asuka, and Taniya, tell us more about dynamic and static stretching.
When we think of static stretching, we think of somebody who's bending over or reaching and stretching out one muscle or one muscle group at a time, like bending over and touching their toes or stretching out their shoulder.
When you're doing static stretching, I compare it to having a tied knot in your muscle tissue. And with static stretching, you're just like pulling the two ends of the knot and making it tighter.
So a dynamic stretch is good for basically getting a good warm up. So you get the heart rate up, you get the blood pumping in the muscles, you bring oxygenated blood to the muscles to make it more elastic. By doing so, you prevent injury because you're making the tissue more pliable.
There's tons of importance behind it, but the main thing is getting your muscles warmed up to prevent injury before you start practices or games.
But then you're also going to have mental benefits. Warming up properly feels good. It gets you ready for the activity, whether it's playing a sport or it's being active in PE or it's going for a run or it's doing a hardcore workout in a gym. It gets you ready, and it also shows that, research shows that it increases your mood. So not only does it make you feel ready for the activity, it also makes you feel really good about yourself and kind of in the zone and ready to go.
Static exercise or static stretch, when you hold it for too long, so say you do your warm up and then you need to stop and do a static stretch, well, sometimes you kind of cool down as you're doing that. Your heart rate drops, the muscles get a little colder, you could be more susceptible to an injury.
If it's an entire team that isn't warming up properly, you're not going to be as effective right when the game starts. It's going to be another 10 or 15 minutes after the game starts when you're going to be ready to go. And unfortunately, at that time, your opponent's probably already has a huge advantage against you on the court or on the field.
A lot of sports teams could benefit from the proper training in, like I said, movement-specific patterns on the field, as well as the proper stretching to help prevent injury.
Sprint! Faster! Pick those legs up! For decades, students have come to Clayton via the BST bus program.
It has raised equity and diversity among our district.
However, it is up for reconsideration.
Michael investigates.
In 2016, Judge Ronnie White ruled that St. Louis schools had not reached unitary status and that schools still had the effects of segregation. But in 2019, schools like Clayton are uncertain about the continuation of voluntary student transfer. So what is the future of the VIC program?
In 1971, VIC was established to rectify the effects of continued segregation in St. Louis schools. VIC was intended to send African American kids from the city to county schools and white kids from the county to city schools. Except, it didn't work out like this and looked more like this. But more on that later. In 1999, on the cusp of a new millennium, there was a large push to declare schools unitary in St. Louis for the purpose that the VIC program would end. However, on the contingency that the program would continue to be funded by the state, schools like Clayton stayed. However, in 2004, there was a large funding cut, nearly 50% decrease in money from the state per transfer student. Schools went from profiting from the program to being in the red. Schools like Ladue exited the program with no substitute. Clayton remained after a large student outcry. So we find ourselves at a crossroads again. The VIC board currently maintains that the program cannot continue in perpetuity and must come to an end. But if a federal judge declared a need for this program just a couple years back, why are schools looking to get rid of it?
As the years wrap up,
Sean and Aaron want to recognize the memories that Clayton has given us.
What did you expect senior year to bring you? Did you enjoy it? Outside of the window, I was sticking with you. We were only seniors, we're almost done. We have a few weeks left until we graduate. In only a few months until we move on to the next stages of our lives. We will become independent, crafting our own lives into our own futures. Clayton, the city, the school, the teachers, the students, the friends, the connections we have made may all fade into memories. We will always have those to connect us back to where we started. From eating late night meals at IHOP to walking in Forest Park, playing spike ball in the quad, we have spent almost two decades here. Now we get to say goodbye. To the teachers, we are so grateful for everything you have taught us. From how to express ourselves in our writing, to expressing ourselves in our lives. From learning how to solve problems in math class, to problem solving with our daily conflicts. From learning about history to creating it. Each one of you have connected to a student, changed their lives, their ideals, their mindsets. Your lessons, both inside and outside of the classroom, will continue to resonate with us as we go on to college, as we create ourselves and grow into the people we want to become. We will always have what you taught us, helping us become those very people. To the students, to our friends, you are what made these years bearable, even enjoyable. With the ongoing stress of high school, you were counselors when we needed to talk to someone, distractions when we needed to unwind, comedians when we needed to laugh. We had early mornings of classes, sports games, debate tournaments, late nights of studying, playing video games, talking until we could barely stay awake. We have made so many memories to relive, and so many that we can revisit as life continues to challenge us. As we continue forward, we have little knowledge of what will face us, and certainly, we will face hardships. But in times of fear, we turn to our connections, the ones that we formed here at Clayton. And whether or not we keep in touch, we will always have those memories of our times together.
Thanks for watching CHS. This has been GET, a production of the Greyhound News Network.
Seniors, good luck on your future endeavors.
And for the rest, good luck on finals, and have a great summer.
Wait, why are we still wearing these?
This has been Eliza
and Caroline
signing off.
Thanks for a great 4 years, CHS.